Good evening. Welcome to TNM News in a Nutshell. My name is Paul Lumen. I'm based out of Hyderabad and I'll be bringing you the latest in the next 5 minutes from across South India. All that's happening today, in less than 5 minutes, I'll be bringing it to you. Let's start off with Telangana. Abundant rainfall in Telangana has improved the groundwater levels in the state. In fact, 543 mandals in the month of October 2020, we have seen a rise in the water levels. And in 46 mandals, there has been a reduction in the water levels. However, out of a total of 33 districts, 27 districts in Telangana have recorded excess rainfall. 6 have recorded normal rainfall, that is 6 districts. And interesting detail is that not even one district in Telangana has received deficit rainfall, which means almost more than 50% excess rainfall recorded across the state, and this has recharged the groundwater because across Telangana we are seeing an improvement in the groundwater levels. Moving on, air pollution levels both in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana this Deepavali has actually seen a dip because this time only green crackers were allowed in both the states. Both in terms of noise pollution and air pollution, both Andhra Pradesh and Telangana have fared quite well because restrictions were in place, that is green crackers only, and also there was a time restriction in place, which means that this has resulted in a dip in air pollution levels. So this comes as good news in both the Telugu states of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana. The second story also important about the Greater Hyderabad Municipal Corporation, which is the local municipal body elections being held. On December 1st, the dates have been announced. That is, on December 1st, it will be held. Polling will be through ballot boxes. And on December 4th, the results will be announced. Moving on, Pawan Kalyan's Janasena party has announced that they will be contesting in the GHMC elections. So this is the second time that the Janasena party is contesting in elections in Telangana. They have contested earlier in Andhra Pradesh, but this time in Telangana, this is the second time, because in 2019 Lok Sabha elections, one of their candidates were fielded from Malkajgiri, and this time will be the second time. So they are in an alliance with the BJP in Andhra. It will be interesting to see how Pawan Kalyan's superstar image will actually benefit both the parties. Moving on, the next update coming in from Karnataka, the tallest Hanuman statue will be installed near Hampi in Karnataka. A trust has announced that the statue will be 215 meters tall and it will be in Pampapur in Kishkinda, which is located on the outskirts of Hampi in the northern district of Ballari. So that is the update coming in from Karnataka. In Kerala, once again gold is in news because gold worth 1 crore was seized from 2 passengers at the Cochin International Airport. In fact, Hasina hails from Kunnamgulam and Shemi Shanawas hails from Malappuram. And they were carrying around 250 sovereigns of gold in the form of biscuits. Hasina was traveling from Dubai to Cochin and Shemi was traveling from Sharjah to Cochin. Both of them had taken an Air Arabia flight, and it is the Air Intelligence Unit of the Customs Department that found gold inside the clothes of both these passengers. So very interesting details there. We have put out a copy. In all these stories that I'm talking to you about, we have detailed copies on the News Minute on our website. You can head there and take a look at these stories in detail. Next update coming in from Tamil Nadu, a TrueJet flight made an emergency landing at the Chennai airport. Fortunately, no passengers were injured. What we are picking up is that there was a landing gear issue. This happened late last night around 9 o'clock. And this was a Belgaum-Mysore sector flight. It was forced to stop and make a landing at Chennai. There were 46 passengers on board, including 5 crew members and 1 infant. Like I said, fortunately, all of them safe. So these are just a very brief version of the stories that we have put out. You can head to our website, thenewsminute.com, and take a look at all these stories from across South. And when it is South, you know your search ends at the News Minute. This is Paul Lumen signing off. Have a great evening ahead.